I get students tell me that they're glad I've talked about a particular topic because they can then take what I've said and use that in their essays. They know that my videos are backed up by references at the bottom of the screen, like this random example. So it's a safe bet, right? Well, no, not really. And here is a comment I received a while ago that I'd like to read out.
Hi Tick, another great video, and your point at the end about historians not telling the truth reminded me of a conversation with my 13-year-old daughter when she said, "How can we learn from history if it's not the truth?" She is having lots of arguments with her teachers at the moment about the Nazis being right-wing, not left-wing. She has been taking notes from your videos to show the teachers, but they still say they were right-wing, and want her to write papers towards her exams saying they were right-wing. She's worried if she explains that they were left-wing in the paper, it will be marked wrong, as the teacher will only go by the curriculum.
Your daughter sounds like she's intelligent, she's obviously eager to debate people, and she likes to speak the truth, which is all great. History lies in the heart of the debate, and these are all good signs of someone who could be really good at history. So I hope she's reading the books, I hope she's coming to her own conclusions, and is looking at both sides of the argument. She should be doing all that regardless of what anyone says. And even though I no longer believe in the political spectrum, I would encourage her to read the book Killing History by L.K. Samuels, which will help her understand the history of the political spectrum. But it pains me to have to tell your daughter this, but you're not in school to learn. You're not there to be educated. You're there to get the grade so that you can then find a career. That's all that matters. At the end of the day, you get a piece of paper with some digits on it, and that's the reason why you're in school. At university, I got given 3 digits, a 2, a colon, and a 1. What does that mean? That means I got into thousands of pounds of debt to waste my youth sitting in boring lectures for many years over a piece of paper with 3 digits on it, because I'm an idiot. The fancy word for this piece of paper is accreditation. That's why you're in the education system. It's to get accreditation, then, supposedly, use that to get a job at Starschmucks. So everything else doesn't matter. Algebra, Shakespeare, French, how to plug in a Bunsen burner, how many friends you've got, who's got the coolest trainers, the Battle of Hastings 1066, none of that matters. It's all noise. What matters is the digit on the piece of paper. That's why you're there. You're also there because it's a babysitting operation that allows women to enter the workforce and soak up that juicy, juicy inflation created by the central banks. But we won't go there because you're a 13-year-old and I don't want to bore you with economics. What I will say is that you need to have the end goal in mind. You're only there to get that piece of paper with the digit on it. Therefore, forget the truth, forget the evidence, forget your morals and ethics, leave all that at the school gates. Whatever it is that your teachers teach you, just pretend that it's true. Yes sir, no sir, kiss your bum sir. Oh okay, Cleopatra is black now, 2 plus 2 is 22, and the moon is made of cheese. Pass the crackers, Gromit. You might think I'm wrong here because we should all aim to fight for the truth. Yeah, in theory, but there are 2 things to consider. One, a 13-year-old girl in school is not the person who should be fighting this fight. Neither is a 21-year-old in university about to sit their exams. It's not your time. And as Sun Tzu says, the best way to win is to win without fighting. So arguing with a teacher isn't going to achieve anything. It's not going to further your goals, and it could even hinder you. And secondly, every individual has a belief system. Belief relies on faith, which is a religious act. You cannot convert someone to a different faith. They must come to that conclusion themselves. People will stick to their beliefs in the face of overwhelming evidence. Tell me about it. So it doesn't matter how many sources, how many books, how much evidence you present, or how compelling your arguments are, or how logical you're being, they will scream at you and call you a Nazi. And that's it. You lose, at least in their eyes. They have their beliefs, and that's all that matters. All that hard work you did to discover the truth is completely worthless, which is why I have lost my faith in humanity. It was on life support when I was in retail, but now it's completely dead. So as depressing as it might be, I have to be honest and say, you cannot win an emotional argument with evidence and reason. You will always lose. And when I hear of a 13-year-old girl presenting evidence to her teachers and being dismissed for that, and potentially getting a bad grade because they can't handle that, I think, no, it's not your battle. You will get a bad grade if you do not tell them what they want to hear. And since you're there to get the grade, just tell them what they want to hear.
And, as another viewer said in response, I'm afraid that's the national curriculum for you. It's designed to teach kids to pass exams, not to think for themselves. So yes, they'll mark her answer as wrong, just because it's not the answer they want.
Exactly. In your head, and when you're outside of school, yeah, think for yourself all you like. Do the reading, write your own arguments, have those debates. But when you're in school, or work, or whatever, just tell people what they want to hear. And this isn't me telling you to lie, by the way. You're not lying, you're just repeating back whatever nonsense they've said to you in the first place. You're just playing the game. It's actually called the game, and it's a bit like catching a ball. They throw you the ball, and you just throw it right back. Here's how to draw a circle with a compass. I love draw a circle with a compass. Here are the first 25 digits of pi. I love pie, especially meat and potato. And by the way, this also applies to when you get a job and end up in an office politics environment. The only exception is if you're in a position like me where you can tell the truth and not instantly get wiped out because of it, although even I'm muzzled at the minute. But regardless, you still got to pick your battles. And I would say that since you're dealing with a belief system, it's better to plant the seed or nudge people than it is to argue with them. I would go so far as to say that you should avoid even mentioning my channel to your teachers. Don't even talk about me. The exception is if they bring me up first, and if they do, then you can gauge their stance and just agree with them. So if they hate me, then you can just say, yeah, I hate them too. And if they don't hate me, then you can have that discussion. But otherwise, keep your mouth shut. The bottom line is this. I want what's best for you. I want you to think outside the box and educate yourself, because that's actually how you learn. You must do the work yourself. So be self-taught, read the books, and get ahead in life. I've learned more in the first year of doing this job than I ever did at university, because I was more eager to learn this topic than trying to learn the nonsense topics they were teaching me back then. So self-education is worth so much more than many people perhaps realize. And even putting that aside, I don't want you suffering just because you said you agree with what I said on a topic. It's in your best interest to just parrot whatever the teachers tell you. So just parrot away. And I'm certain that this video will be controversial, and I can't wait to hear what people have to say about it. But if you think going through the education system is worth it in a financial sense, you might be shocked to discover that a plumber is much better off than a university lecturer. Check out my video on that discussion here, and I've just published it alongside this one, so there's two videos on the same day this week. Thanks for watching, bye for now.